Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 19th annual Miss LSU USA pageant. We hope you are all as excited as we are. We have an eventful evening here, and we plan on the beginning. In the beginning, we ask that you stand and welcome to the stage the Tiger Tenors to sing the national anthem. Please stand.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Wow, thank you, gentlemen. I want to welcome you again to the Miss LSU USA 2018 pageant. I'm your host this evening, and my name is Leonard Augustus. Is everybody ready to meet these women? If so, come on. Give a round of applause for your Miss LSU USA 2018 delegates. Yeah. Welcome to the stage, your Miss LSU USA 2017, Alyssa Caesar. Thank you. Here she is, ladies and gentlemen, your 2017 Miss LSU USA, Alyssa Caesar. Wow. Hello, Alyssa. Wow, what a great performance. A special thank you to Shayna Grace and Katherine Johnson, the two LSU Golden Girls who choreographed our opening number. Give them a round of applause, please. And now, without further ado, let's meet your contestants.
I might have grown up in Lexington, and I might have grown up sporting Kentucky blue, but it didn't take long for me to start loving purple and living gold. I'm a political science and religion major, and Louisiana's unique politics and culture sure have given me a lot to learn, but even more to love. Hoping to represent the number one school in my heart, LSU, I'm contestant number one, Brooke Justice.
Usually marching in for the Saints, but tonight I'm marching in for the title of Miss LSU. A junior biology major from Denham Springs, Louisiana, your contestant number two for the night, Hayden Harris.
Good evening, my name is Brooklyn Farley and I'm contestant number three. As a resident assistant on campus, I work with students who create the heartbeat of LSU. I aspire to enact groundbreaking changes in the field of law as a constitutional lawyer and future U.S. Senator. Again, I am contestant number three, Brooklyn Farley.
As a Delta Zeta, I'm normally pink and green, but tonight I'm all purple and gold. I'm a freshman majoring in mass communications from Denham Springs, and I'm contestant number four tonight, Skylar Harris.
All the way from the bottom of the boot in Houma, Louisiana, your contestant number five, Amelia Jordan.
Hoping all my fine me lady brugs bring me lots of luck tonight, I'm a junior from Alexandria, Louisiana, majoring in marketing, contestant number six, Natalie Nicholson.
Someone call a doctor. Someone call for help. A student is bleeding purple and gold. Here I am, your future ER trauma surgeon and contestant number seven, Erica Grant. While my dream is to help the helpless worldwide, no matter where I go, I'll be sure to bring my spicy Louisiana stride. Again, I am contestant number seven, Erica Grant. Bye, y'all.
Catch me flying high over Tiger Stadium. A junior studying physical theater from Covington, Louisiana, I am contestant number eight, Daily Andrus.
From Madisonville, Louisiana, a small town with big family values, sophomore children and family studies major and representing my Tiger family tonight as your contestant, number nine, Kaylee Kelly.
Normally, you can find me competing in courtrooms, but tonight, this future attorney is competing on the Miss LSU stage. I'm your senior mass comm major who's attending LSU in the fall. I'm contestant number 10, Emily Dillon.
As a true multimedia artist, tonight, pageantry is my medium. A senior studio arts major from Bossier City, Louisiana, I am your contestant number 11, Priscilla Lustig.
A double major in biology and philosophy, this senior involved in student government and volunteering is all about giving back. Tonight's contestant number 12, Christina Black.
People may call me Teddy Bear, but I roar like a tiger. From Baton Rouge, Louisiana, I'm contestant number 13, Teddy Page.
Running from rehearsal and reporting live from Miss LSU 2018, this future professional oboist and sports reporter is ready for the symphony and the sidelines. From Niceville, Florida, I'm Olivia Rackley, contestant number 14.
From the state known for its Lambo leap, this Wisconsinite is hoping to leap into the judges' hearts tonight. I'm contestant number 15, Sophia Pullman.
Just a small town girl living in a purple and gold world. From St. Francisville, Louisiana, I'm contestant number 16, Paige Gall.
Hoping to help future little tigers roar a whole lot louder, I'm your contestant number 17, Allie Williams.
My heart plans the way, but the Lord directs my steps. Born and raised in Tiger Country, I'm contestant number 18, Alyssa Davis.
Bonjour tout le monde. This junior and future student body vice president from Mandeville, Louisiana, studying political communication, political science, and French, souhaite bonne chance pour tous les candidats. Je suis contestant number 19, Rachel Campbell.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm a classy, sassy, and oh-so-chic Southern belle. Hailing from the beautiful city of Kenner, Louisiana, I'm an entrepreneur in the making with a passion for fashion and who dreams big and never gives up. Tonight, my dream is to become the next Miss LSU. I'm contestant number 20, Maya Colbert.
Last but not least, a junior majoring in mass communication with a minor in French. From Lake Charles, Louisiana, I am your final contestant, number 21, China Paris.
The young woman who has been such an outstanding ambassador for LSU this past year, your Miss LSU 2017, Alyssa Caesar. Alyssa has spent the last year appearing as special guest in both LSU and Baton Rouge community events. She had the honor of being a celebrity waiter benefiting Baton Rouge Children's Advocacy, where she helped raise money alongside Coach Paul Maneri and the cast of Swamp People. She also spoke on a panel for Big Buddy's Career Day to address insecurities and how to overcome them. She presented the LSU rings to the future graduates at the LSU ring ceremony and rode in the LSU homecoming parade, just to name a few. Ladies and gentlemen, she's your Miss LSU USA 2017, Alyssa Caesar.
Good evening, everyone. Just want to welcome y'all to the 19th annual Miss LSU pageant. How's everyone doing tonight?
Alyssa is a fabulous group of young women here, but I can tell you right now, every one of them is on an emotional roller coaster. They're on their bad nerves, their excitement is and anxiety is rising. It's a ride I'm sure you're all too familiar with. What are those girls going through right now, do you think?
Well, it's definitely a whirlwind of emotions. I remember competing here last year and oh my gosh, I was a mess. But I think it's all about being yourself and letting the judges really know who you are and what you represent. And also just leaving it all on the stage and letting the judges decide.
Yeah. As Miss LSU USA 2017, you've been invited to appear at many different events around Louisiana. I know it's probably hard to pick just one moment, but tell us about one thing that was a highlight on your reign.
I definitely have to say being presented on the field. I was a student all 4 years at LSU, and I've been to all the football games, season tickets. I love LSU football, but being on the field is just completely different. And I got to meet Odell Beckham, so that was the highlight.
Oh. That's pretty good. You're leaving some big shoes to fill. Ladies and gentlemen, you'll hear and see more of Alyssa later tonight. But how about another round of applause for your Miss LSU USA 2017, Alyssa Caesar.
Thank you.
Earlier this morning, the contestants competed in the interview portion of the competition, but now the contestants have two more rounds before we narrow down to our semifinalists. For the upcoming swimsuit competition, these women will be judged on beauty, overall fitness, and self-confidence. Ladies and gentlemen, the swimsuit competition. Contestant number one, Brooke Justin. Brooke is 5'8", her hair is brown, and her eyes are blue. Her hobbies include keeping up with politics, traveling, spending time with friends and family, reading and playing with her dog, Katie. In her free time, Brooke interns with a political fundraising company and plans campaign events for various Louisiana elected officials. Ladies and gentlemen, Brooke Justin. Justice. Contestant number two, Hayden Harris. Hayden is 5'9", her hair is blonde, and her eyes are blue. Hayden enjoys volunteering in the weekly buddy program at St. Lillian's Academy. She says the kids bring a smile to her face. She loves networking and meeting new people. She also enjoys performing on the sidelines at Saints games in the Superdome. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number two, Hayden Harris. Contestant number three, Brooklyn Farley. Brooklyn is 5'5", her hair is black, and her eyes are brown. Her hobbies include yoga, cinematography, and poetry. She also is involved in a number of on-campus organizations such as Student Government, Society of African and African American Studies, and Phi Psi Theta Honor Society. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number three, Brooklyn Farley. Contestant number four, Skylar Harris. Skylar is 5'2", her hair color is blonde, and she has blue eyes. Skylar has many hobbies, including writing, knitting, drawing, baking desserts, reading whatever she can get her hands on, and helping the environment by recycling. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number four, Skylar Harris. Contestant number five, Amelia Jordan. Amelia's height is 5'10". Her hair is light brown and her eyes are blue. Amelia's hobbies include running the lakes around campus and volunteering at the Greater Baton Rouge Food Bank. Amelia is also very passionate about the Boys and Girls Club. Here, she tutors and mentors children after school while trying to be the best role model she can be. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number five, Amelia Jordan. Welcome contestant number six, Natalie Nicholson. Natalie is 5'8", her hair is brown and her eyes are blue. She loves working out with friends and trying new, fun, exciting exercise classes. Classes that involve dancing are her favorite. She also enjoys walking around the LSU lakes. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number six, Natalie Nicholson. Contestant number seven, Erica Grant. Erica is 5'9". Her hair is black and her eyes are brown. Her hobbies include traveling, rollerblading, spending time with her mom, and trying new foods. She also donates her time to the community by volunteering at the local food bank and at the homeless shelter. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number seven, Erica Grant. Welcome contestant number eight, Daly Andrus. Daly is 5'1". She is blonde with blue eyes. Daly loves aerial silks, weightlifting, and everything physical fitness. In her free time, she also loves to read, cook, travel, write on her blog about eating disorder recovery, and spend as much time outdoors as she possibly can. She hopes to use her newfound strength to perform in Cirque du Soleil someday. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number eight, Daly Andrus. Welcome contestant number nine, Kaylee Kelly. Kaylee is 5'3", blonde, and has hazel eyes. She is a member of the Zeta Tau Alpha sorority and enjoys spending time with her fellow sorority sisters. She also likes to hit an Evolve Burn or Pilates before class. When she is not spending her time on campus, She nannies three loving and energetic children. Contestant number 9, Kaylee Kelly. Contestant number 10, Emily Dillon. Emily is 5'4". She is blonde with blue eyes. And Emily's hobbies include serving as vice president to the LSU mock trial team and competing in mock trial competitions, working with her not-for-profit, The Dance Project, which she founded to promote confidence in preteen girls, and competing in 5Ks that support local causes such as St. Luke's Cancer Research Ministry. Your contestant number 10, Emily Dillon. Welcome contestant number 11, Priscilla Lustig. Priscilla is 5'7". She's blonde with blue eyes. Her passion for fitness has given her the exciting opportunity to model for clothing boutiques and manufacturers in the fitness industry. While maintaining her busy schedule, she also volunteers with several local organizations such as Knock Knock Children's Museum, the LSU Museum of Art, and St. Lillian's Academy. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 11, Priscilla Lusting. Contestant number 12, Christina Black. Christina is 5'4". She has brown hair and green eyes. Christina is involved on campus with Student Government Senate and her sorority, Phi Mu. Her hobbies include visiting with others, reading, volunteering, listening to music, playing piano, exercising, cooking, and spending time outside. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 12, Christina Black. Welcome contestant number 13, Teddy Page. Teddy is 5'3". She's blonde with green eyes. Her hobby includes cycling at tread, working hard at Baton Rouge Orthopedic Clinic, and spending time with her Delta Zeta sisters. Teddy also volunteers at the Family and Youth Services Center, helping Baton Rouge youth overcome obstacles by emphasizing the importance of education. Number 13, Teddy Page. Contestant number 14, Olivia Rackley. Olivia is 5'5", caramel hair with light brown eyes. She has been a musician since she was 4 and can now play 6 different musical instruments and currently plays the oboe in LSU Symphonic Winds. She is in the process of becoming a Manship School Ambassador and is also a sports reporter for LSU Tiger TV. She hopes to one day be an on-air reporter for a major network while performing in movie score orchestras on the side. Contestant number 14, Olivia Rackley. Welcome contestant number 15, Sophia Pullman. Sophia is 5'4", blonde with blue eyes. Sophia's favorite hobby is working towards making her Jackets of Joy campaign, a nonprofit organization. To date, she has raised $21,000, resulting in over 1,500 jackets being distributed to kids throughout the state of Wisconsin who cannot afford jackets in the cold seasons. Welcome contestant number 15, Sophia Pullman. Contestant number 16, Paige Golf. Paige is 5'7", brown hair with hazel eyes. Her hobbies include yoga, bar classes, golf, running, dog rescue, country music, LSU football, and her sorority, Kappa Delta. Welcome contestant number 16, Paige Golf. Contestant number 17, Allie Williams. Allie is 5'4". She has light brown hair and brown eyes. Her hobbies include working with LSU Mental Health Center, dancing, softball, working out, attending LSU events, and raising awareness for CASA with her Kappa Alpha Theta sisters. Welcome contestant number 17, Allie Williams. Contestant number 18 is Alyssa Davis. Alyssa is 5'2 with light brown hair and she has blue eyes. Alyssa is an outdoors fanatic. She enjoys hunting, fishing, LSU athletics, dancing, and listening to live music. She is passionate about serving her community with nonprofit organizations such as Susan G. Komen and Live to Serve Christian Ministry. She is a proud recipient of the Outstanding Student Volunteer and More Than Pink Hero Award. Welcome, contestant number 18, Alyssa Davis. Here is contestant number 19, Rachel Campbell. Rachel is 5'4". She has light brown hair and blue eyes. Rachel loves the great state of Louisiana and everything it offers, from crawfish and king cakes to New Orleans art and LSU football. Rachel wants to make sure the traditions she loves so much stick around as long as possible by becoming Louisiana's best advocate for public and higher education, as well as coastal restoration. Welcome, contestant number 19, Rachel Campbell. Contestant number 20, Maya Colbert. Maya is 5'3". She has brown hair and brown eyes. Her hobbies include blogging, traveling, going to sports events, concerts, modeling, competing in pageants, volunteering in the community, and spending time with family and friends. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 20, Maya Colbert. And now contestant 21, China Paris. China is 5'7", blonde with blue eyes. Her hobbies include reading, writing, volunteering, spending time with family and friends, and playing with her Frenchie Piper. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 21, China Paris. Let's keep the ball rolling and go right into the evening gown portion of the pageant. In the evening gown competition, each contestant is judged on her overall appearance, sense of style, beauty, and self-confidence. Welcome contestant number one, Brooke Justice. Brooke's best asset is her strong work ethic and determination to reach the high goals she has set for herself. Her life motto is, "I'd rather have 30 minutes of wonderful than a lifetime of nothing special," which is a quote from her uncle, who she is competing in Miss LSU in honor of. Brooke's biggest accomplishments include receiving a presidential scholarship to LSU, which is a full ride scholarship awarded to the top 10 entering freshmen each year, and being accepted into U.S. Senate Bill Cassidy's internship program on Capitol Hill for summer 2018. Your contestant number one, Brooke Justice. Welcome contestant number two, Hayden Harris. Hayden believes her best asset is her resilience, because no matter what life has thrown at her, she has bounced back. Hayden's life motto is, "Fall down 7 times and stand up 8. Look up, get up, and never give up." She believes her biggest accomplishment is staying true to herself through every hardship, every failure, every accomplishment, and everything in between, and giving glory to God. Contestant number two, Hayden Harris. Welcome, contestant number three, Brooklyn Farley. Brooklyn's best asset is her adaptability. Her life motto is to always be open to new opportunities for growth. Brooklyn's biggest accomplishment is that she was accepted into the Alvin Ailey Dance Theater Summer Intensive and was offered a full ride to attend the Ailey School. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number three, Brooklyn Farley. Welcome, contestant number four, Skyla Harris. Her best asset is her joy for life. She looks forward to every day and makes the best of it. The optimism and passion in her heart spreads to everyone's life she touches. Skylar's life motto is look up, get up, and never give up. Her biggest accomplishment is living every day to the fullest and helping in any way she can. Contestant number four, Skylar Harris. Here's contestant number five, Amelia Jordan. Amelia's best asset is her empathy and compassion towards people. She always strives to reach out to those in need and lift the spirits of others. Her life motto is to be somebody who makes everybody feel like somebody. She believes it is vital to make each and every person feel special and, most importantly, loved. Amelia feels her biggest accomplishment has been in fostering the nurturing academic success in the students she has tutored and mentored. Welcome, contestant number five, Amelia Jordan. Here's contestant number six, Natalie Nicholson. Natalie's compassion for others is her best asset. She feels that in children and the joy she feels when she is able to help and encourage them. Her life motto is to achieve success, surround yourself with greatness. Natalie's biggest accomplishment was traveling to Guatemala on a mission trip where she worked with Hope of Life International. Prior to the trip, Natalie raised enough money to give Max Lucado's book, You Are Special, to each child in the orphanage. Her time in Guatemala showed her how a small gesture can go a long way and make a lasting impact. Contestant number six, Natalie Nicholson. Contestant number seven, Erica Grant. Erica's best assets are her enduring spirit and her outgoing personality. Erica's life motto is to be yourself. Life is not a competition, and you must move at your own pace to reach your destination. Even though it may feel like it's taking a while to get there, eventually, you will get there. Erica's biggest accomplishment was when she was chosen out of her peers and teachers to attend a leadership conference for future doctors at Johns Hopkins University. Ladies and gentlemen, number seven, Erica Grant. Welcome, contestant number eight, Daily Andrus. Daly's best asset are her big heart, her courage, and her love for helping others. Her life motto is a quote from Walt Disney: "It's kind of fun to do the impossible." Daly has overcome a lot of adversity in her life and thinks this quote represents her well. Daly's biggest accomplishment was being cast as a character performer during her internship in the Disney College program. Contestant number 8, Daly Andres. Welcome, contestant number 9, Kaylee Kelly. Kaylee thinks that her best asset is her compassionate heart. She loves being able to give of herself and help others. Kaylee's life motto is, "Seek the Novelist." This motto is from her sorority, Zeta Tau Alpha. It means to go above and beyond in everything you do. It is a daily reminder for her to live every day to the fullest and be the best version of herself she can be. Kaylee's biggest accomplishment would be co-founding the organization NOLA Paying It Forward. This was started as an effort to help the victims of the Oklahoma tornado tragedies after they welcomed her family and friends during the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina. It is a big life lesson in all areas. She hopes to have paid it forward by example in her actions and not just her words. Contestant number 9, Kaylee Kelly. Welcome to the stage, contestant number 10, Emily Dillon. Emily believes that her best asset is her drive and perseverance. She never gives up when she sets her mind to something. Her life motto is, through big dreams, persistence, and by never accepting no for an answer, anything can be achieved. Emily believes that her biggest accomplishments include her acceptance to LSU's Paul M. Hebert Law Center and the foundation of her organization, The Dance Project, which was a free summer dance camp for underprivileged girls dedicated to promoting confidence and positive body image. Contestant number 10, Emily Dillon. Welcome, contestant number 11, Priscilla Lustig. Priscilla believes that her best assets are her unbreakable confidence and her tireless work ethic. Her life motto is, do the best you can until you know better. Then, when you know better, do better. She believes her biggest accomplishment is launching and expanding her first successful business while being a college student. Welcome, contestant number 11, Priscilla Lustig. Here's contestant number 12, Christina Black. Christina's best asset is her creative problem-solving ability. Christina's life motto is to strive for improvement, not perfection. She believes mistakes of the past must not prevent us from embracing the present or looking forward to the future. Time will continue on, and we can either lose it or we can use it. Christina's biggest accomplishment has been developing her public speaking skills and leadership abilities through her service as the events, logistics, and hospitality coordinator for Stripes and her work throughout the Student Government Senate. This is contestant number 12, Christina Black. Welcome, contestant number 13, Teddy Page. Teddy believes her best asset is her optimistic attitude. She lives by the motto, keeping moving forward. Never dwell on the past and the things we cannot change, but instead look at the possibilities that will come your way in the future. She encourages young women to set goals and work hard no matter what doubts or worries you have. She believes her biggest accomplishment is being a scribe for Our Lady of the Lake Emergency Room. She says, assisting doctors as they save lives is the most rewarding feeling. Contestant number 13, Teddy Page. Here's contestant number 14, Olivia Rackley. Olivia's best asset is her perseverance. Pursuing two completely different things has been tough, but she tells herself what her dad always said. Focus on the task at hand. And she fully believes that she can fulfill her dreams that she set for herself at 6 years old. Olivia's life motto is a quote from Henry Ford. Whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. Olivia's biggest accomplishment was receiving her flagship academic scholarship and her music scholarship to LSU. LSU is the perfect school for her, and she feels so blessed to have been granted a full ride here, able to study in the Manship School and the school in the LSU School of Music. Contestant number 14, Olivia Rackley. Welcome, contestant number 15, Sophia Pullman. Sophia's best asset is her self-confidence. She learned at a young age that you could accomplish great things if you love yourself. If you don't have the confidence to believe in yourself, then no one will. Her life motto is, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Philippians 4:13. This was the favorite scripture of her best friend, Ellie, who recently lost her life in a fatal car accident. Sophia's biggest accomplishment is winning the Community Service Award at Miss Wisconsin. She takes great pride in her volunteer efforts. Please welcome contestant number 15, Sophia Pullman. Here's contestant number 16, Paige Golf. Paige feels that her best asset is having compassion for others. Being the sensitive person she is, Paige can never sit back when someone else is hurting or in need. Paige's life motto is her favorite quote, "We get so worried about being pretty. Let's be pretty kind, pretty funny, pretty smart, pretty strong." Paige feels that her biggest accomplishment is the stage in life she is right now. She says that all of the large and small accomplishments throughout her life have played a part in where she is today. Welcome, contestant number 16, Paige Golf. Here's contestant number 17, Allie Williams. Her best asset is her smile, because it is the best way to spread happiness to others. Allie's life motto is, I alone cannot change the world, but I can cast a stone, across the waters to create many ripples. Her biggest accomplishment is placing top 10 in the Miss Louisiana USA pageant. Your contestant number 17, Allie Williams. Here's contestant number 18, Alyssa Davis. Alyssa's best asset is her compassionate love for others. She is motivated by her desire to serve her community, and her purpose is to exude God's mercy. She uses every opportunity to inspire others through any adversity. Alyssa's life motto is, "The secret to having it all is believing you already do." Alyssa's biggest accomplishment is being elected as pledge educator for Alpha Kappa Psi Professional Business Fraternity, where she has successfully guided and developed the future business leaders of LSU. Contestant number 18, Alyssa Davis. Welcome contestant number 19, Rachel Campbell. Rachel's best asset is her positive outlook. Rachel wakes up every day with a glass half full, which helps her conquer any challenges the day may bring. Rachel lives by the words of 2 Corinthians 12:10. "That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weakness, in insults, in hardships, in persecutions, in difficulties. For when I am weak, then I am strong." Rachel's biggest accomplishment is successfully lobbying LSU's Student Senate to fund TurboVote LSU. TurboVote LSU is a program designed to make it easier for college students to register to vote and get civically engaged. This is the first step on Rachel's work to consolidate a polling place on LSU's campus. Here's contestant number 19, Rachel Campbell. Welcome contestant number 20, Maya Colbert. Her best asset is her personality. She has a big heart and loves to care for others and make them smile. The motto that Maya lives by is a quote from her mother, which states, "Anything is possible, dreaming required." It reminds her that with her hard work, dedication, and determination, she can accomplish all her hopes and dreams, and the sky is the limit. Maya's biggest accomplishment so far is getting the opportunity to attend her dream university, LSU. While she has truly blossomed into a vibrant, confident, and beautiful young woman that steps out and tries new things. Number 20, Maya Colbert. Welcome contestant number 21, China Paris. Her best asset is her ability to see the goodness in everyone she comes into contact with. She lives her life by believing that the world can always be made better through human improvement. Her biggest accomplishment so far is being crowned Junior Teen Louisiana, along with being signed with Factor Women Modeling Agency at the age of 14. Your contestant, number 21, China Paris. Well, ladies, the competition is now mostly behind you. What an honor to have so many beautiful, talented young women grace our stage. Now, ladies and gentlemen, take one final look at your beautiful 2018 contestants, one of whom will soon be your next Miss LSU USA. I now have the honor of announcing to you the semifinalist in the 2018 Miss LSU USA pageant. All right, here we go. This is also something you always hear, but I'm going to get to say. In no particular order, our first semifinalist is number 9, Kaylee Kelly. Holy smokes. Wow. I want to be your best friend just so you can bring your crowd to my parties. Number 2 of the top 5 is number 13, Teddy Page. Number 3, Brooklyn Farley. Now that was really tricky because you're number 3 and you're number 3. So that worked out well. Contestant number 4 of the top 5 is number 14, Olivia Rackley. This is where everybody wants to throw up, I'm sure. Our 5th and final contestant of the top 5 is number 16, Paige Goff. All right, ladies, take a deep breath. Congratulations on making it this far. The next phase of tonight's competition is the onstage question. Each contestant will pick a slip of paper containing their question. All questions are of the same level of difficulty, and some were submitted by the contestants themselves. Audience, we want you to know our policy on this segment of the competition. Each of these questions are issue-oriented. The type of questions our winner will face at Miss Louisiana USA. The judges are not scoring the contestants based on their personal stance or beliefs. Rather, they're judging her answer based on whether she is knowledgeable of the topic, an intelligent opinion, and reasons to back it up. All right, contestant number 9. Yeah, I guess that'll help. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
Don't be nervous.
I'm not. I'm like not that nervous.
Not that nervous.
Not that nervous.
Okay. Let's see. All right. According to the National Alliance on Mental Health, 1 in 5 Americans experience mental illness in a given year. However, many college students do not seek treatment due to the stigma against mental illness. What can you do to help end the stigma against mental illness?
Thank you so much for that question. First of all, my platform is suicide education and awareness, number one. So as Miss LSU, I hope to bring the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention Walk to LSU's campus for one of the campus community walks. I also want to open up LSU's resources for mental health, saying that we have anonymous calling that you can come in if you need help. You can make an appointment with the Mental Health Center. LSU has resources for you and wants to help you. And as Miss LSU, I hope to do the same. Thank you.
Wow. She said she wasn't nervous, but I didn't believe you. That was amazing. Next, we'll have contestant number 13, Teddy Page. Fantastic, thank you. Good luck. All right. Are you nervous?
A little bit.
A little bit. Are you nervous?
Yes, I'm nervous. Yeah. I love that you're like helping me. You're going to be okay. All right. Oh, wow. Great question. Binge drinking is a serious issue affecting college campuses throughout the country. What resources would you suggest LSU offer to promote responsible drinking?
I do believe that binge drinking, drugs, any type of abuse is a serious problem around campuses, not just in Louisiana, but across the world. And I believe that if you're not under 21, there should be no excuse for drinking. And, you know, if you're at a bar, you need to make sure that they, well, not just a bar, but anywhere, they need to make sure that you have the proper wristband and everything else so that you can properly drink. And that's pretty much it.
That's excellent. Thank you. Thank you. They're doing great. I mean, I'm scared, but y'all are doing really great so far. Now we have contestant number 3, Brooklyn Farley. Hi, how are you? Are you nervous?
A little bit.
A little bit? In a good way.
In a great way.
I hope so. All right, here we go. Oh my gosh. All right. It is anticipated that the Louisiana legislature will have another special session this year to attempt to address the significant budget shortfall. How can LSU students get involved in the discussion about budget cuts to higher education?
Thank you. I think that LSU students should get involved with local government. So that means writing to your senators, calling your senators, letting them know that it is imperative that politicians and people in power invest in Louisiana education system, because this is a system that will produce the greatest minds of tomorrow.
You bet. Felt like I dropped the mic. Contestant number 14, Olivia Rackley. Hi, how are you? Same question, you nervous?
Yes.
Yeah. All right, here we go. All right, I'm glad this one's cut thinner, maybe it's shorter. Okay. Man, and some of you came up with these questions yourselves. Yeah, tough. Okay. Based on the increasing number of hazing incidents, what changes can LSU students make on an individual basis to stop these type of incidents from occurring?
I think that LSU students should speak up. If you see something, say something. I know a lot of students here at LSU are participants in the Greek life. I'm not one of them, but I am directly involved with a lot of them. And we have experienced ourselves and across the nation way too many injuries and deaths caused by hazing in Greek life. And I think that the rules that the Interfraternity Council has obviously are not working very well. We've had a recent death this past year of freshman Max Gruber in the Phi Delta Theta sorority. And it kind of just vanished. We all kind of went back to normal. And I don't think that's tolerable. I think that students should, again, speak up, talk to your representatives within your fraternity or sorority, and put an end to these injuries and deaths within Greek life. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Finally, contestant number 16, Paige Golf. Hello. How are you?
Good.
You look great. You don't look nervous.
I'm definitely very nervous.
Very nervous. Okay, well, it's okay. It's going to be okay. Now, this is interesting. There's still two questions in there, and you get to pick one of them. So good luck. I did trick you. That's the tag at the bottom of the bowl. I'm trying to make her loosen up.
It's working.
It's working? Good, good, good. All right. Final question. Of all SEC schools, LSU has the lowest applicant retention rate, meaning that although we have a high application rate, many potential students choose to attend college elsewhere. Aside from what you can read on the LSU website, how would you encourage potential students to attend LSU?
Not only LSU, but Louisiana has such a vibrant and rich culture that makes it unique from any other university, rather in the United States. I would tell this student that walking around campus, you're gonna see cool people like Leonard Fournette. But also, we offer a wonderful education, many student services to offer with the help of, to help with the transition from high school to college. And also, we love purple and we live gold each and every day as a student on this campus. You know, coming to LSU, you carry it on the traditions that you learn here. You carry those with you throughout your entire life. And being an alumni of Louisiana State University really is something to be proud of.
Thank you very much. And speaking of being proud, aren't you proud of these five finalists? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, let's take a good look. Tonight's competition is over. And one of these women will soon write her name in LSU's history by becoming the next ambassador of this university as Miss LSU USA 2018. Ladies, thank you so much.
Sunshine on a cloudy day, and it's cold outside. I got the month of May. Well, I guess you'd say, what can make me feel this way, my girl? Talking about my girl.
I've got that honey, yeah, the bees envy me. I've got a sweeter song than all the birds in the trees. Well, I guess that you'd say, what can make me feel this way? My girl, talking about my girls, my girls. Oh.
touches, baby, one man can claim. Well, I guess that you'd say, what can make me feel this way, my girl? Talking about my girl, my girl. Talking about my girl, my girl.
This is that ice cold Michelle Pfeiffer, that white goat. This one's for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces, styling, wilding, living it up in the city. We got Chuck's on with Saint Laurent. I gotta kiss myself, I'm too pretty, I'm too high. Call the police and the fireman, I'm too high. Make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too high. You say my name, you know who I am, I'm too high. And I'm bad about that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch.
She's a brick house. She's my tomate, just letting it all hang out. She's a brick house. That lady stacked, and that's a fact. Ain't nothing holding back.
Wait a minute. Fill my cup, put some liquor in it. Take a sip, sign the check. Julio, get the strap. Ride to Harlem, Hollywood, Jackson, Mississippi. We show up, we gon' throw down, cause I'm smoother than a fresh dry skippy.
She's a brick house. She's my tomate, just letting it all hang out. She's a brick house. There's ladies stacked. Ain't nothing holding back.
Before we leave, we want to tell you something. Uptown funk you up, 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 uptown funk you up. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause uptown funk gon' give it to you. Cause uptown funk gon' give it to you. Uptown funk gon' give it to you. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Don't believe me, just watch.
The LSU Tenors, everybody. As you might already know, the Miss LSU USA pageant is nationally recognized as a part of the Miss USA circuit and is a preliminary to the Miss Louisiana USA pageant. The winner tonight will go on to represent LSU at the Miss Louisiana USA pageant this October. And here with us tonight is your current Miss Louisiana USA 2018, Lauren Vizza. All right.
Hi.
Hi, good to see you.
It's good to be in some tiger country. You can't really drive into the 225 without knowing where you are.
Where you are. You look beautiful tonight.
Thank you.
As usual. As you might already know, the Miss LSU, Lauren. First of all, congratulations.
Yes, thank you.
I'm sure you understand the nerves, excitement, and anxiety that these ladies are going through right now. Please tell us a little bit about how your experience as Miss Louisiana USA has been so far.
Well, it's been absolutely amazing. So I won this title back in October, and it was my fifth try. I never, ever, ever, ever thought I'd give, first of all, pageants, but really anything, 5 years to compete. You know, I thought somewhere maybe year three, if I didn't win, there's a sign from God that I should quit, you know? So it's amazing what will happen if you don't give up. Sometimes, you know, your dreams might look a little bit different. You might think the outcome should turn out differently, but you never know what the hidden message is going to be in there, what your life might turn out. And to know that I'm standing on this stage as Miss Louisiana USA and in a few months competing for Miss USA, absolutely incredible.
Awesome. What can these young ladies expect when this one winner becomes the winner for tonight? What can they expect?
Well, I think it's about who's going to win Miss LSU USA. She's got a full-time job ahead of her. Everyone's going to know who she is on campus. You're instantly recognizable. But it's about the other women that are here as well. And, you know, we're hoping that they take a lot from this experience. And for many of them, that Miss LSU is their dream. Miss LA USA is their dream. They come and compete in October and get that practice in and work on it. I mean, you're going to have the honor and the joy no matter where you are, no matter, you know, who wins back here, who doesn't. They're going to always be connected to LSU, and you're always going to know that they're somehow representing LSU. And so we're just excited. I'm excited to be here on behalf of the entire Miss Louisiana USA and RPM organization. We're excited, and you'll probably be hearing from some of us. So the parents out there, you know, if you think, "Whoo, I'm off the hook. My daughter maybe didn't win tonight. I don't have to pay for it." No, not so fast. We're going to do some work on that.
Well, we can't thank you enough for being here. You look beautiful, and we're so proud of you, and we
thank
hope
you
to see great things from you in the future.
Thank
Ladies
you.
And gentlemen, Miss Louisiana, Lauren Visit. All right, now, of course, crowning a new Miss LSU USA means saying goodbye to the young lady who has worn the LSU crown with dignity and honor this past year. What a special year 2017 was for Alyssa. Ladies and gentlemen, for the final time, your 2017 Miss LSU USA, Alyssa Caesar.
How bittersweet it is to return back to the same place where my journey began. A year ago, I stood on this very stage in hopes of being able to represent something so much bigger than myself. I am still so humbled and so grateful to have been given the opportunity to make a lasting impact on my campus. First and foremost, I'd like to thank God for His grace when I don't deserve it and for continuously blessing me. Mom, Dad, Addison, and Khadijah, y'all are my heart and soul. Thank you for constantly pushing me to follow my dreams and being there for me every step of the way. I love you guys. To Empowering Crowns, I could not have done this without you. Thank you for coaching me to be the best me that I could be. But most importantly, thank you for believing in me and giving me the confidence I needed to rock it on stage. I love y'all. To my friends, family, and Pi Phi sisters, God has blessed me with the best friends and family a girl could ask for. I cannot thank y'all enough for all the love and support you have shown me over the years. To Delta Zeta, Jim Compton, Ms. Vicky and Ryanson Runway, Verde, Katie Barnett, and all of my sponsors, thank you for making my year the absolute best year yet. I love you all so much. Being Miss LSU has given me the opportunity to travel across the state and raise awareness for students with mental illnesses and advocate against sexual violence on campus. John F. Kennedy once said, "Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country." At the end of the day, it is not about what being Miss LSU can do for you, but what you can do for others as Miss LSU. To my successor, take this crown and enjoy every minute of it. Nothing in the world is comparable, and it is just the beginning to a remarkable journey. If you leave empty-handed tonight, remember that no crown or title determines your worth. You are enough. Tonight, I am closing the most beautiful chapter in my life yet. Thank you to everyone who played a role in my journey. I cannot wait to see what adventures God has in store for my life. And for the last time, I am your 2017 Miss LSU Alyssa Cecil.
I think you did that when you won. You walked in a circle. Miss Alyssa Cecil, everybody. So this is such a bittersweet, emotional moment, letting go of a title that has meant so much and looking back a year that you'll never forget for the rest of your life. Alyssa has done a superb job of representing this university, and we wish her the best of luck in her future. Now let's bring out all of our wonderful contestants again. You ladies have made us all so very, very proud, and I know that your family and your friends are elated, and they're so proud of you, and we know that you're proud of yourselves for what you have done and what you have brought to this stage. Such grace, such class, such honor. You're all winners. Presenting the awards this evening are members of the Miss LSU Committee. Among them, the Executive Director, Diana Grace Garriso, Carolyn Cincy, Mary Frances Orcoin, Ellery Lachleche, and Janae Marie Hidalgo. All of these Southern names that a Southern boy should be able to say. This incredible fundraiser would not be possible without the dedication and hard work of these women and the entire Miss LSU Committee. Let us certainly not forget the Delta Zeta Alumni Advisors, Ashley Corville, Jody Loop, and Monica Rogers, who dedicated many hours to this event and to these young women. And now, please pray that I do not pull a Steve Harvey. Earlier this evening, our wonderful judges voted for Miss Photogenic 2018 based on contestants' photo headshots taken by Katie Barnett with Vivid Dream Photography. And our winner for most photogenic is contestant number 16, Paige Goff. After getting to know each other during practices, the contestants then voted on the 2018 Miss Congeniality. Congratulations to contestant number 11, Priscilla Lustig. Now, we can't forget the winner, you, as our audience choice. We have tallied up the votes, and our 2018 Fan Favorite Award goes to my Miss LSU is number one, Brooke Justice. Next up, we'll be announcing the winners for Best Interview, Swimsuit, and Evening Gown. Best in Interview goes to contestant number three, Brooklyn Farley. Best Swimsuit goes to contestant number 14, Olivia Rackley. And And best evening gown winner is contestant, wow, number 14, Olivia Rackley. Congratulations, ladies. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you have all been waiting for. Who among these five beautiful ladies will become Miss LSU USA 2018? Let's have one more round of applause for all of tonight's contestants. And now, let's start with the fourth runner-up. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's fourth runner-up is number 13, Teddy Page. Tonight's third runner-up is contestant number 16, Paige Goff. Am I supposed to have a bulletproof vest at any point? Contestant, the winner of the second runner-up is number 9, Kaylee Kelly. Wow. And then there were two. Ladies and gentlemen, please be advised that if the reigning Miss LSU USA cannot fulfill her duties, the first runner-up will take her place as Miss LSU USA 2018. The first runner-up is contestant number 3, Brooklyn Farley. Miss LSU USA, contestant number 14, Olivia Rackley. Olivia Rackley is this year's Miss LSU USA 2018.
It's a lot of stuff.
Well, thank you so much for attending tonight and for making this the most successful pageant ever. Best of luck to Olivia. And we hope to see you next year. There will be opportunities for photos. The contestants will go on either side of the stage. We ask that nobody come on stage. But have a great evening. It was great being your host.